Hello everyone, and today in this class we are going to perform multiplication of vectors. In our previous class we have discussed about the addition, subtraction of the vector, and today students we are going to discuss about the multiplication of vectors. Students, whenever you will study about the multiplication of two vector quantities, you will observe that whenever there is a product of two vector, the result is of two types. First one, when two vectors are multiplied, then the result is scalar. In such cases, the product is called scalar product, because the product of two vector quantity is a scalar quantity. Second one, when the product of two vector is also a vector quantity, is called vector product, because the answer is the vector quantity. And so students, in this class we are going to discuss about the two types of products of vectors. Number one is vector product, and second one is the scalar product. Students, in first we are going to start to discuss the scalar product. Scalar product means when the product of two vector quantities is a scalar quantity. For example, work is equal to force into displacement. Here force is a vector quantity, displacement is a vector quantity, but the result is a scalar quantity. Second example is power is equal to force into velocity. Force is a vector quantity, velocity is a vector quantity, but power is a scalar quantity. Similarly, flux, in whenever we will discuss the electric flux, it is denoted by the phi, it is equal to the product of electric field vector and area vector. Here you can see the product of two vector quantities is a scalar quantity. And these are the examples of the scalar product, where two vectors are multiplied and the result is the scalar quantity. Students, now we are going to discuss how to perform the product of two vector quantities. Students, here suppose you have a vector A and another vector B, and the angle between A and B is the theta. Suppose we have vector A and B, and angle between A and B is the theta. Then the product of these two vectors is denoted by the A dot B. Students, to perform the scalar product, we will use the symbol dot. Then A dot B is equal to mod of vector A, mod of vector B cos theta, where theta is the angle between A and B. Students, means here whenever there is a product of two vector is a scalar quantity, that is the called scalar product, and also known as dot product, because here we are using the symbol dot. Then it is denoted by the mod of A, means magnitude of A, into magnitude of B multiplied by into the cos theta. In another way, you can write, if the projection of vector B is B cos theta. We have discussed that a vector has two components, horizontal component and another one is the vertical component, B sin theta. Then you can see the dot product is equal to the one of the vector and horizontal component, means projection of the another vector. And this is called the product of two vectors, where the result is a scalar quantity. Now we are going to discuss some cases. Number one is when theta is equal to 0 degree. Suppose here the angle between two vectors is the zero, then the result is vector A dot vector B is equal to mod of A mod of B cos 0, and we all know that the value of cos 0 is 1. Then here the result is cos 0 is will be 1 mod a into mod b. In second case, students, when theta is equal to 90 degree, suppose theta is equal to 90 degree, then what happens? Then cos 30 will be equal to the 0, and you will get the product of these two vectors, means the scalar product will be the 0. Means, students, when you want to prove that the two vectors are perpendicular to each other, then what you will do? You will perform their scalar product. And if the answer is 0, then you will verify that these two vectors are the perpendicular to each other. Because when the theta is 90, then two vectors are perpendicular to each other, and in such cases their dot product will be 0, because cos 90 is equal to the 0. The third case, students, in third case, suppose theta is equal to 180, and you all know cos 180 is equal to minus 1, then for that case, vector A dot vector B will be equal to the minus vector A and vector B, because cos 180 is equal to minus 1. Students, now we are going to discuss some different cases. Students, our next case is the case number 4 is we are going to perform the product of orthogonal unit vector, means I cap, J cap and K cap. You all know about the I cap, J cap and K cap. I cap represent a unit vector along X axis. J cap represent the unit vector along Y axis. And K cap represent the unit vector along Z axis. Then students, we are going to perform the product of I cap, J cap and K cap. For product of I cap and J cap, K cap, first of all, we are going to multiply I cap dot I cap. Here we are going to take a scalar product of I and I. Students, you all know very well, vector A dot vector B is equal to mod of A. Mod of I will be 1 because it is a unit vector. Mod of B, mod of I will be 1 cos, and the angle between two similar vector will be equal to the 0. And this result will be 1 because cos 0 is 1. Second, J dot J. Here, this is vector A, this is vector B. Then mod of A, mod of B, cos 0. Again, the theta will be 0 and the answer is 1. Similarly, students, K dot K. For K dot K, mod of K is 1, mod of K is 1, and that is cos 0, then result is again 1. Means, whenever we multiply I dot I, J dot J and K dot K, their the scalar product will be equal to the 1. But when you multiply two different unit vectors, like if you multiply I dot J, suppose we are going to multiply I dot J, then what will be the result? Mod of I is 1, mod of J is 1, cos, and theta will be, I is the X axis and J is the Y axis. Then student, the theta will be 90 degree because the angle between X axis and Y axis is the 90 degree. Then what will be the result? Result will be 0 because cos 90 is equal to the 0. Isn't similarly, if you multiply J dot K, again the result will be 0 because the angle between J and K will be 90 degree and cos 90 is 0. And last, K dot I will be 0. Means the product of similar vector will be 1 and product of two different orthogonal unit vectors will be the 0. Okay, students, now we will discuss few more points. Students, now let us multiply a vector which is in the xyz plane. Consider we have a vector A is equal to A1 I cap plus B1 J cap plus C1 K cap. And there is another vector B, that is A2 I cap plus B2 J cap plus c2 k cap, and we want to multiply these two vectors. Then students, here we are going to perform again a scalar product. Students, since we have discussed that as we will multiply these two vectors, then the similar multiplication will produce 1, but when you multiply I with j or I with k, it will be equal to the 0. Because we have discussed that I dot I is equal to 1, but I dot j will be equal to the 0. There is no need to multiply the another vectors, only we will multiply here the similar vectors. Then you will get a1, a2. Multiply directly I, the product, the coefficient of I with the I, coefficient of j with the j, and coefficient of k with the k. Then you will get a1, a2 plus b1, b2 plus c1, c2. Suppose you have two vectors, vector a is equal to I plus j minus k, and vector b is equal to I minus j plus 2k, and you want to perform a dot b. Then what will be the result? You will directly multiply. The coefficient of I is 1 and 1, it will be equal to the 1. Here 1 and there is a minus 1, it will be minus 1, and here minus 1 and 2, 2 1 ja minus 2. The result is minus 2. Listen, this is the process of multiplying two different vectors which are in the xyz plane. Now we will discuss about the cross product, means vector product. Students, when two vectors are multiplied and their result is a vector quantity, then such type of product is called the vector product, and we are going to perform this product. Students, suppose we have two vectors, and these two vectors are A and B. Suppose we have two vectors A and B inclined at an angle theta, and we want to perform their vector product. As I told you, when the product of two vector quantities also vector quantity, such type of products are called vector product. For example, there is a quantity torque, and torque is equal to R into F. Here R and F both are the vector quantity, and torque is also a vector quantity. Students, here this is called the cross product, because for scalar product we have used the symbol dot, and now for the vector product we will use the symbol cross. Then suppose we have a two vector quantities A and B. These two vector quantities A and B are inclined at an angle theta. Then the cross product of these two vector quantities denoted by the vector A cross vector B, means vector product. And this will be equal to the mod of vector A mod of vector B sine theta. Here at the place of cos there is the sine theta. And the student, since this product is a vector quantity, since this product is a vector quantity, the result is a vector, then a vector should have the direction. And to represent the direction, we have used the unit vector. Then here, you will apply a unit vector n cap. N cap means normal. Students, means the resultant have a direction. When there is a cross product or vector product, the result have a direction, and the direction of result is perpendicular to the plane of A and B. Suppose this is the vector A and this is the vector B, then their cross product will be in this direction. A cross B means the A and B both are perpendicular to the A cross B. Or you can say the A cross B will be the perpendicular to the both of the A and B. And the direction of A cross B can be determined using right hand screw rule. Suppose your curl finger are representing the angle from A to B. Suppose the curl finger is representing the angle from A to B. Then the thumb will give the direction of A cross B. And that's why here the symbol n cap is used. N cap for normal to the plane of A and B. फ्रेंड्स नाउ वन मोर ज्योमेट्रिकल डेफिनेशन ऑफ ए क्रॉस बी इज देयर. सपोज ए एंड बी बोथ आर कंबाइनिंग टुगेदर टू फॉर्म अ पैरेललोग्राम. सपोज बोथ ए एंड बी आर कंबाइनिंग टुगेदर टू फॉर्म अ पैरेललोग्राम. देन द वर्टिकल कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ बी विल बी द बी साइन थीटा. एंड यू ऑल नो दैट द एरिया ऑफ पैरेललोग्राम is equal to the base into height. Base is the A, this is the base is the A, and height is the B sine theta. And you can see that the area of the parallelogram is equal to the cross product. Now students, we will discuss few cases of this cross product. The first one is when theta is equal to zero. Theta is equal to zero means when two vectors are parallel to each other, then we say that the theta is zero. When the theta is zero means the A and B both are parallel to each other. For such cases, we will write A cross B is equal to mod of A mod of B sine theta, where theta is the zero and sine zero is equal to the zero. You all know sine 0 is equal to the 0 and the answer will be the 0. Means when the two vectors are perpendicular, their dot product is 0, and when two vectors are parallel, their cross product will be 0. Okay? Now students, suppose we have two vectors. Number one is a1 I cap, b1 j cap, c1 k cap, and vector b is the a2 I cap, b2 j cap, and c2 k cap. And we want to perform vector A cross vector B. In the case of dot product, we have directly multiplied a1 a2, b1 b2, and c1 c2. But now we will multiply in a different manner. This is just like the cross product method. We have studied in class 10th. You will write I cap, J cap, and K cap. Now write the coefficients of I cap, that is A1, A2. Coefficient of J cap, B1, B2. Coefficient of K cap is the C1, C2. In next step, write I cap, bracket, minus J cap, bracket, plus k cap, bracket, I minus j plus k. And in bracket, what we have to write? For the I cap, cover the I cap and use the cross multiplication process. This will be the b1 c2 minus b2 c1. For j cap, cover the j cap and again use the cross multiplication, up to down, down to up, A1 C2 plus B2 C1. And last, for the K cap, you will cover the K cap and again write the cross multiplication. Well, this will be the A1 B2 minus A2 B1. This is the process of multiplying the vectors in the plane using the cross product. We have an example. Suppose a vector A is 2i cap minus j cap plus k cap, and vector b is I cap plus j cap plus k cap, and we want to perform A cross B. Then what we have to do? First of all, write I cap, j cap, and k cap and their coefficient. 2, 1. Here minus 1, 1, here 1 and 1. Now I cap bracket close minus j cap bracket close plus k cap bracket close. For I cap, cover the I cap and multiply it. This is the minus 1 and minus 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 1. Here for j cap, cover the j cap, 2 1 jar 2 and 1 1 jar minus 1. And last for k cap, cover this k cap and write 2 1 jar 2 minus 1 1 jar minus 1. And solve this. We will get the answer minus 2 I cap last minus j cap and plus 3 k cap. This is the cross product. Then these are the methods of multiplication of vector using dot product and cross product. Students, in our next class we will discuss about the different types of motion in the plane, and actually vector is an important tool for them. Then please revise the vectors, and if you feel any problem then kindly ask them. Thank you students, thank you for watching.